Good evening and welcome to the Sheikh Zayed Stadium here at Abu Dhabi, where we've just witnessed day three of the first test between England and Pakistan. The staff are fervently cleaning up the mess behind us from the Pakistani fans here today, and I'm privileged to be joined by Pakistani cricket journalist Hassan Cheema. Hassan, thanks for joining us. What have you made of today's play?
Thanks. And regarding the day, I think it slightly... Obviously, England had the better day. Slightly unexpected for Pakistan because they've sort of gotten used to putting up a big score and using the wicket and the heat, using that to their advantage. The touring side, a lot of times we've seen them, once they come out to bat after Pakistan put up a big score, what they do is they capitulate because of the fitness factor. So right now, we'll talk about him later as well, but I think Alastair Cook's innings is one of the most remarkable I've ever seen.
And as you said, it very remarkable. And the way that England didn't capitulate today, as you say, stands out compared to other teams that have come over here. There's a big man missing for Pakistan, that is Yasir Shah. Would he have made a difference?
Mushtaq Ahmed in the press conference right now just said that of course he would have made a difference because he's someone who naturally gets the zip off the wicket, who has a little bit of overspin. But the other thing that he mentioned, and which is something we've discussed as well, is that this pitch is slower compared to what even Abu Dhabi generally is. We talk about slow wickets in the UAE, but this wicket is a sort where you can adjust off a good length, even if you're beaten in the flight. So obviously Yasir would have helped, but I don't think the match would have been that different. The one thing that would have been different would have been the composition of the Pakistan bowling attack, because with Yasir there, what Misbah would have had was Zulfikar Babar controlling one end, Yasir attacking from the other, and the occasional spurt from Wahab Riaz. Instead, what he had was Zulfikar trying to contain an attack and Wahab Riaz trying to do those things as well. And perhaps given both of them given more responsibility than they would have expected or they would want on a wicket like this. So the only thing you can say about the Pakistani bowling is that they toiled very hard, they bowled really well considering they restricted England to less than, I think, about 2.5, 2.6 today. Mm-hmm. But again, the credit goes to the English team, and of course, Pakistan will rue the missed chances, one easy one and one which I thought was a difficult one, Mushtaq didn't.
And just to finish, 3 days in, we've seen 13 wickets and over, 600, 700 runs. Can anyone win this test match?
There are two possibilities of a possible result. The one is, which is something that Pakistan would be hoping for, that tomorrow is a new day, they start off, they get, probably Cook would be their main man. If they get Cook early, then you've got people like Bairstow, Stokes, Butler, very good players, but naturally aggressive players, which isn't the natural thing to do on a wicket like this. So if they can restrict England to, let's say they have a lead of 100, they bat for the rest of day four, they put up a target and try to bowl England out on a deteriorating day five wicket. That's the option for Pakistan to win. For England to win, they bat for like two or three sessions tomorrow, and with Pakistan, even with whatever they've put up over the past 18 months, whatever they've put up in the UAE, there is always this possibility of Pakistan collapsing wherever they are. So you could see England get close to their target and Pakistan getting bowled out for 150 even.